I hit $28,000 in less than 18 days, starting from $0. Yes, you heard it, in less than 18 days. This is real life and real results, and that is why I always say invest in people who are doing exactly what you want to be doing in this world. In this video, I'm going to be talking about my exact strategy that I took this brand new product starting from $0 and how I was able to accomplish these results. The steps that I took along the way, how to implement this for yourself, and of course, what you can be able to do to be able to take action today. And remember, if you're feeling stuck at any point inside of this video, or you just need some questions answered, you know I'm here to help out in any way possible. Go to my Instagram at @AC_Hampton and DM me the word YouTube. Not only can you just reach out to me on Instagram, but you also get the opportunity of winning an absolute free consulting call to streamline your success with e-commerce. All you have to do is follow these three simple steps, and the winner of last week will be announced somewhere inside this video. The first thing you must do is go to my Instagram at @AC_Hampton and go ahead and follow me. The second thing you must do is smash that like button below and subscribe to my channel, as I've never missed a single week on this platform. And the third thing you must do is in the comment section below, comment the word strategy and what your biggest takeaway was from this video. All right, without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into it.
I need to know everything, who and the what and the where, I need everything.
So as you guys can see, it is 3:13 p.m. and I'm currently at $1,000 in sales today. And you know I'm always gonna refresh the screen because you know it's always no cap. So yep, we're at around $1,000 in sales today. I started this product on the 23rd. Today is currently the 9th, and I'm at $28,449 starting from zero. And what is revenue if you cannot show profit? We know men lie, women lie, numbers don't. So let's go ahead and check out what the profit was. As you guys can see, this is the exact same time frame of July 23rd to August 9th. The revenue was the same of $28,400. The product cost was $6,400. The marketing cost was $15,000, which ultimately brought a profit home of $5,400 starting from zero. So now that we were able to cover the profits, let's go ahead and check out how I was able to achieve these exact results in less than 18 days. When first starting off, I always start off with product research and product validation. This is the part where most beginner dropshippers and even experienced advanced dropshippers still struggle with finding winning products. So if you guys want to know my exact strategy on how I'm able to take product after product and make a winner from it, make sure to check my exact product research methods in this video right here. So after completely validating the product, the next thing that I do is structure a high converting product page. And remember, I'm never trying to be able to reinvent the wheel, so I love to be able to replicate what my top competitors are currently doing and allowing it to work for me. But yes, I take a lot of what they're doing and a lot of what's working for them, but of course, to be able to wipe out your competition, you always have to be able to do it better. Whether this is switching up features and benefits or high quality images, or maybe changing your gifts on your product page or your reviews, no matter what, you always have to give yourself a competitive advantage. So whatever you do, just make sure you do it better. So after I structure this high converting product page, the next step that I usually get into is creative testing. This creative testing is allowing me to validate what advertisement is going to allow me to win the bid against my competition. So this is where I'm effectively testing out different scroll stoppers, thumbnails, headlines, and even videos to see which one is going to perform the best for me. And for this product that I'm currently testing today, that's exactly what I did, was get into creative testing first. I put myself in a position of being 100% confident in exactly what I was going to use, and that is why I was able to hit results since day one. And for you to be in a position to know and be confident in doing creative testing, I've already dropped an entire video about this, so make sure to go ahead and check it out right here. So what do I do whenever it comes to actually running my advertisements? So when it actually comes to running my ads, after doing creative testing, the first thing that I get into is cold audience interest testing. And I typically do this with a CBO. And if you guys don't know, there's two different campaign types that you can be able to set up. One is considered a CBO, which is a campaign budget optimization. And the second is an ABO, which stands for ad set budget optimization. So what the ABO does is set the budget on the ad set level, and the CBO sets the budget on the campaign level. So with an ABO, you can see that you're setting a $10 budget on each ad set and just hoping for the best results. And then with a CBO, you take that same $30 and you just let it disperse amongst your best performers. So whenever I first start off for the interest testing campaign, I do like to start off with a CBO at $100 to allow my money to be able to spread across the board and see whatever is going to work and allocate that budget towards it. So I still do use CBOs, but I like to use them more when I'm scaling. So for example, if an asset is doing really well in my CBO, I might duplicate that into a new campaign, and then I will set the budget on the ad set level and just push more towards those winners. And then so when I'm doing this, I'm gathering more and more data, and then I get into what I call horizontal scaling and vertical scaling. So if you have ran any ads on Facebook before, the best thing that you can do is allow the algorithm to work for you. And the easiest way to be able to do this is with horizontal scaling. So with this, what you're doing is allowing your Facebook pixel to work for you. And the easiest way to be able to do this is test more audiences. You will truly never know what's going to work for you until you try it out. So here's an exact example of horizontal scaling. So for this example, you can see this interest is doing really well. It spent $100, it has a return of 321, which is giving me a ROAS of 3.20. So what's the easiest way to be able to do horizontal scaling off of this? Is I'll simply click edit, I will scroll down, and I will just take suggestions of what is working and continue to allow more and more stuff to work for me. Just like joint, shoulder, neck, vertebral column, these are all other suggestions that I can horizontally scale with. So the next scaling method that I love to be able to take advantage of is vertically scaling. So this is just pushing more and more budget to what is working for you. In my original cold interest testing campaign, I saw 5 interests were doing the best. So I put those in a new campaign and I scaled them with a higher budget. And it's not doing too bad. As you see, they spent $196 for a return of $416. So again, the two methods of scaling that I love to take advantage of is horizontal and vertical. And trust me, I know that this can be a lot of information and it can definitely be overwhelming. So if you're having any difficulty or experiencing any trouble when it comes to being able to run your ads, again, all you have to do is go to my Instagram at @AC_Hampton and DM me the word YouTube. I've always wanted to be somebody who could provide a solution in any way possible, so I'm always going to be here to help you guys out. So now with there being so much information out there in the market, especially when I'm talking about things like this with Facebook ads, it's very, very important that you understand how to read your data. And the easiest way for you to be able to do this is focusing on your front end metrics. So the main front end metrics that I'm looking at on all campaigns that I run are cost per click, click through rate, cost per 1,000 impressions, average video watch time, and cost per link click. It's very important that you understand this data and what it means so you're able to make executive confident decisions in everything that you are doing. And not are just front end metrics really important, but you also need to understand what your cutoff metrics are. And I'm not gonna go into too much depth about this, but understanding exactly what your break even is and when to be able to cut your ad sets is also very important. And I make sure that you understand this completely with my KPI calculator. This KPI calculator is available to all the people in my one-on-one mentorship or in my blueprint course. And this teaches you important criteria like what is my break even cost per purchase, or what is my break even ROAS, or what do I need to be able to do to cut my ads to be able to make 20% profit. This is when the KPI calculator comes in handy, and I make sure to take full advantage of that on every store that I run. All right, so the next thing that I like to do whenever I'm gathering enough data and I'm ensuring that my product can sell is get into lookalike audiences. And if you guys are currently running Facebook ads today, you definitely know about iOS 14.5 and how this is not tracking all of your data correctly. And with this, some of those audiences that you're using for your lookalikes are not populated. But with problems, there's always solutions, and I'm here to be able to give them to you. So with some of your data not being tracked properly, the easiest and most confident decision that you can make is gathering more data. By doing this, you're giving yourself the opportunity to have a bigger pool of people to choose from these audiences, and having more of an accurate description of who your customer is. So with lookalikes, the first audience that I typically tested was 95 and 75% audiences. So before this update with iOS 14, I was typically running my 95 to 75% custom audiences to 2,000 video views. I would run this to 2,000 video views before I actually start running them. So with now creating stronger and stronger audiences, I don't run my 95% video views until this custom audience has over 5,000. So yes, over 5,000 95% video views, because it's gonna give me confidence that this is going to work for me. Less data, less confidence. More data, more confidence. And over here, I wanna be confident with everything that I'm currently spending my money on. And by doing this, I'm giving myself the best chance of success. And how you set up your lookalike campaign is very similar to exactly how I set up my CBO cold interest. But instead of choosing 10 different interests, I always test out the 1 through 10% of these lookalikes. So again, I'll run this with a CBO at $100 a day with 10 different ad sets with 10 different percentages of lookalikes. And lastly, for purchase, add to cart, view content, any of those different type of custom audiences, I now wait till I have over 500 conversions to start running those. And with this, successfully getting to this point and doing things outside of just lookalikes is going to only increase your ROI. So when you are running this interest testing campaign, you're getting a better understanding of who your ideal audience is. While you're running your lookalikes, what you're doing is you're allowing your pixel to understand who your target audience is. Both of these together is going to put you in the best position as a marketer. And then from here, it's all about capitalizing on what is working for you, letting the data tell you what and when to be able to push, and then just repeating this process to see sustainable success. Using these exact strategies to be able to combat iOS 14 and scale up my store has allowed me to get to $28,000 revenue in less than 18 days, making over $5,000 profit. All of this from starting from $0. And I hope this video has helped you and you can implement these same strategies on your store so that you can be able to scale to the moon. And I also hope that you watched last week's video to give yourself the opportunity of winning an absolute free consulting call to streamline your success with e-commerce. Because the winner of last week's video is Markai. Markai, congratulations on winning. Go ahead and reach out to me on Instagram at @AC_Hampton and let me know that you won this free consulting call. We can hop on a Zoom call, look at your ads manager, your Shopify store, your product research, and help you out in any way possible. Again, congratulations on winning. And if you guys want the opportunity of winning an absolute free consulting call next week and a special giveaway, make sure you do all three of those requirements that I mentioned at the very beginning of this video. I'm here each and every single week helping you guys be able to run successful e-commerce brands, and I've never missed a single week since I've started. So make sure to go ahead and show me some love, smash that like button below, and subscribe so that we can be able to continue to drop these value pack bombs every week. I appreciate each and every single one of you guys being a part of my Supreme family, and let's go ahead and continue to create this generational wealth with each other. This is AC, and I'm out. They gon' want a piece when you got it like that. Like Jake said, we gon' spend it, get it right back. Stack that internet money to the site crash. They on IG, try to get a like back. See, they don't talk that.